Hi, welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and with me is Simon Perryman, a senior technical evangelist here at Microsoft.
Thanks for having me.
Well, today we are talking about the MCSE for private cloud. So the first exam up is 7247, configuring and developing a private cloud with System Center 2012. So as most people know, we use experts from all over the world to really figure out what we should have on these exams. We fly people in, we pick their brain. Most of the time, those are external to Microsoft, and you're a rare exception, aren't you?
That's right. You know, I was fortunate enough that I could kind of help out with MSL, give some best practices, some kind of key learning areas as they were working through the development process. So it's been kind of fun for me, both kind of seeing the development piece of this, actually taking the beta exams myself, taking the real exams, and then, you know, ultimately getting the certification at the end.
So tell us a little bit about your background. What brings you to System Center?
Sure. So I'm a technical evangelist, and that basically means that I sit between engineering and marketing and really kind of fill in a void where they need marketing people need technical help, or technical people need marketing help. And so I was able to really help out Microsoft Learning just because they said, hey, you know, we're part of the same organization. We need some more technical guidance. The set of system set to products is kind of new. There's a lot of new things. There's Orchestrator, which is brand new. Few people are using Service Manager. App Control is brand new. So they really wanted to get someone that had some, I guess, real-world experience,
yeah.
Spoke to a lot of customers, so we could really try to build the exam around what people are really doing or what we're trying to get them to do as we move towards this vision of the private cloud.
And that real-world experience is really important to us. In fact, if I'm Johnny System Center working at Initech and I want to get my private cloud MCSE, you have an interesting idea on where to start.
Yeah, so, you know, as you're kind of thinking about which exam do I take first, there's this one that's on configuring, and then the second one that's more around monitoring.
Yep.
And so, I guess in my opinion, I would recommend taking different ones kind of based where you are today with your own knowledge of System Center. And so by that, if you're kind of brand new, starting with things the first time, I'd recommend taking this exam first, because this really kind of helps you set the foundation as you're really designing the topology, the architecture, figuring out the different sites, different locations, and then deploying the components in the correct order. So you kind of get things set up before you actually go and start using it.
Sure.
Now, on the other side, if you're more familiar with day-to-day operations, you've been using all of these components for a while, Ops Manager, Virtual Machine Manager, Config Manager, you'll probably find it easier just taking the monitoring exam first.
Okay.
So you kind of have that day-to-day familiarity.
Mm-hmm.
So again, if you're new, I'd recommend configuring. If you're experienced, I'd recommend starting with the monitoring.
Okay. Well, a lot of people think, oh, I'm just going to take the lower number first, but there's actually some thought that you need to put into it.
Yeah, definitely. You know, as you really plan, you want to be more comfortable. You know, what I was kind of surprised with these exams taking it myself was they're actually pretty hard. I'll be honest, and this may surprise some people, I actually failed both exams first time I took them. I walked into them cold. I thought, hey, I know System Center, right?
Yep.
And my experience, I was pretty good with Virtual Machine Manager, pretty good with Ops Manager, but I never used Service Manager. I barely used Orchestrator.
Yeah.
And so you're kind of going into these exams and thinking, hey, I'm really deep in this one area, I'll be able to pass. Not the case with these ones, because we really are testing all of the knowledge across all the System Center products.
Sure.
So if you've never used Service Manager once, you're not going to pass this exam. It's a lot of Service Managers. So, you know, we really do want to try to encourage people to don't just walk into this cold unless you really do have kind of a broad skill set covering all these different System Center components.
Sure. And that makes me, as an exam developer, feel good that you needed hands-on experience to actually pass the exam.
It's trusted. And I really think that this gives our exams more credibility as well.
Sure.
Because, you know, if you could just walk in an exam and pass it, okay, that means the exam has so much value. But if it's tough and our employers know it's tough,
yep.
Right, it's kind of a higher bar to pass it, that makes the exam more valuable and ultimately, you know, that should give you more confidence, more credibility when you get that award.
Absolutely. So this exam starts with designing and deploying System Center itself. Why is it important to get that right?
So great question. As we kind of think about the architecture with the System Center release, it's really a more integrated component. And what I mean by that is previously with the System Center product, speaking from the engineering perspective, we had individual teams that built each product. So you had just the VMM team. They were kind of siloed, just the ops manager team, kind of siloed. And so as the products came out, you know, they didn't have the best integration story necessarily.
Mm-hmm.
Now with this release, we're actually shipping everything the same time, the same cadence. And part of that's because we've actually reorged our engineering teams. We now have a single team there's all of the system center products. And so they're really ensuring the pieces are working together. And so as we kind of think about, you know, why is this important to get the configuration? It's because it's such an integrated product.
Sure.
And that's one of the key things that we're really trying to highlight with this release, the system center integration. They all built using the same kind of runtime, similar binaries, similar agents. And so our goal here is to have this as a single product. And, you know, kind of a mind shift in the way you want to think about the product is, instead of thinking of System Center as a group of individual products, yeah, we now want to think of it as the single product with eight components. And you could kind of draw a parallel to what Windows Server is, where you buy Windows Server as a single product, then within that you get Hyper-V, Active Directory, File Services as kind of these different components.
Yeah.
And so to become an expert in Windows Server, you kind of got to know all of them. It's the same thing now with System Center. To be a System Center private cloud expert, we want experience across the board, all of these different components.
Well, and you mentioned this is the first time they all come out at the same time, and I think that was really important. I remember when we first started to combine them that it was just, we said an integrated solution, but it was just an MMC with two separate InOpsMan and ConfigMan window.
Right.
It's really nice to see it really meet its potential, if you will.
It is, and you know, it makes it a stronger product because now we're really thinking not just what can this one piece of System Center do. We're thinking about how can we stretch it across these different components. You know, you get an alert in Operations Manager that creates a ticket in Service Manager, which invokes an automatic runbook, a runbook automation activity, yeah, in Orchestrator. And so this really gives us these concepts of the private cloud as we're kind of moving away from just managing a data center to really optimizing it and get these best practices of pooled resources, metering, automation, and self-service. And that's when we really see all these different pieces come together as the single product, giving you all those capabilities.
So one of the things that we test on is Fabric, and there's a lot of configuration. One, what the heck is Fabric? I mean, people ask me that all the time, and what does Microsoft mean?
That's a great question. And as you kind of look at the learning objectives on the page, you'll see there's a big topic on Fabric.
Sure.
Right? So what we define as Fabric is basically the key infrastructure. And so this is generally using Virtual Machine Manager to go and provision your storage, your networking, your clusters, your Hyper-V hosts, and then that kind of support and infrastructure around it, such as Windows Server Update Services for patching, Pixie Servers for booting, and then even vCenter or Xen Servers, because, you know, Virtual Machine Manager also manages VMware, also manages Citrix Xen Hypervisors. So when we mean the Fabric, we're talking about that hardware that provides that foundation for everything else you're doing in the infrastructure.
One term you mentioned earlier was private cloud, and I think that's another term that a lot of people are a little confused about. What the heck is a private cloud, and what does Microsoft mean by it?
Great. So our private cloud, we're really thinking about how we can take our data center to the next level, really build in automation, self-service, and better enable our end user. So as we're kind of thinking of the Microsoft private cloud model, the four key areas we are really focused on are pooled resources. And so that's kind of aggregating your storage, network, compute, and making it available for any application or resource to use. The next thing we have is metering. So basically being able to better understand how the resources are being used by all the individual tenants as well. And this way you can do chargeback, showback, basically better have better resource utilization metrics. Now the next two are going to be more commonly used, as I think, as we talk about private cloud with our automation and self-service pieces.
Sure.
And so with private cloud and automation, our goal here is to free up time for our infrastructure specialists. We start to think about repetitive tasks, such as patching a cluster, where mm-hmm. you're draining hosts, moving things around, very repetitive task. Onboarding new users in Active Directory is another good example. It's filling out a form, a standardized series of steps.
Sure.
And so our goal with private cloud is thinking, what can we repeat? What's repetitive? What's a standardized set of steps? And then let's automate that. We then take it a step further with self-service, and instead of saying, hey, why should the IT guys push the button that says automate? Let's let our end users push that button that says automate.
Yep.
Present them with a self-service portal. They make the request. Under the covers, that request is automatically processed. And then our goal is to really free up time for the IT guys, right? If they're no longer doing these repetitive actions, they're investing their time in new products, mm-hmm. new services, really adding more value to the business. And so as we kind of think about moving towards this private cloud model, we're thinking about benefits not just for the business, not just for the IT department, but also for this individual IT guy, because he's now offering better services and helping their business be more dynamic. And so great reason why you want to think about this certification, moving towards that next level, advancing your career, becoming more valuable in your own company.
More valuable, I think, is a key in today's market.
Definitely.
So that's a really good summary. And I think the key point is that we test on all of this stuff, that these tests really go through the gambit.
Absolutely.
Of what everything you were describing, everything that's involved with the System Center suite.
Absolutely. And, you know, if you're really trying to look for more ways to go learn about this, there's a few resources that we really want to recommend. The mock courses from Microsoft Learning are a great way to really get a full week of training, a lot of hands-on as well.
Yep.
We have the Microsoft Virtual Academy, www.microsoftvirtualacademy.com. And we have courses on configuration, deploying, virtual machine manager. So a lot of kind of those core fabric configuration topology type courses for System Center as well. So a lot of great resources available online too.
Great. Well, thanks, Simon, for being here.
Thanks so much. And good luck, everybody. And please don't forget to study. You're going to need it for this one.